Hello everybody. Hey, how are y'all managing in this lockdown? Me, I can't make it there. 6 days now, I just can't make it. You know, I always said I married Biggs for better and for worse. But for the last 6 days, I only seen the worst of him. True, I just can't make it. You know, all that time that I said I can't live without him. That's a lie. I can actually live without him. Now, all of y'all, please stay inside your houses so that the lockdown can get over faster and, you know, the virus can all disappear so we can come out of our house. Because of y'all, now I'm stuck with this man here, those who are not listening. I'm stuck with him here inside the house. Hey, but today I got a chance and I went to out of the house. No, you not for nothing. I went to go collect my pension. Anyway, Biggs and I, we went early in the morning. We collected our pension. I said, let me buy a few things for the house. And then I wanted to buy something, essential things, you know. So I went there and I took one broom. That man telling me I can't take the broom. This Big's got nothing better to do. He's standing and laughing at me. He's saying, oh, you're taking that transport home. What he's trying to say? I look like a witch. And is that what this man is trying to say? Yeah, I was very irritated with this man. Anyway, I said, come Big's, let's just go, man. Came up at the house, he dropped me off and then he went to take his sister. I was so happy because first time she didn't have to be in the car with me at the same time. So he had to drop me and take another one and go pick up her pension. I came home now. I said, let me clean up a little bit. I can hear the neighbors out there shouting at their children, man. Now that makes me wonder what my daughter-in-laws must be going through. You know, every time they're going to say, what? My mother-in-law is like this. My mother-in-law is like that. Now what they must be saying? They had the children, but the mother-in-law only had the granny. Look after the children, brought them up. We don't shout at our grandchildren, no matter how much nonsense they can do, they can turn the house upside down too. I'll never ever shout at my grandchildren because we, I love my grandchildren. But now, I can hear how the neighbors are screaming. So all your daughter-in-laws who take advantage of your mother-in-laws and you'll say, what, we cunning, we cruel, you're complaining by the husbands, you're complaining by our sons that we bad. Now I hope you'll eat your words. Because we look after your children when y'all at work, y'all don't know what we're going through, but we don't complain. So what y'all shouting at the poor children for? Anyway, leave all that story, but just look after the children nicely. Eh? My two daughter-in-laws, Charlene and Cheryl, I hope they look after him. So now this Biggs now, he went to Rasodi. And he came back, he's sitting tired. What's so tired? You only drove and went to go collect a pension. What you so tired for? Then I told him, you know what, Biggs, how many days I'm washing it? Ugh. So many days, man, I'm telling you, to go and wash the windows. Hey, but you're not going and washing the windows. You expect me to do it. Then he's saying, no. I heard his hand is paining. Why is it only when we ask them to do work, they get some body pain? Yeah, I was very irritated and I just pulled my face and I went to it. Then I see, today it's raining. Eh? Raining, so heavy the rain is. But this man is taking the bucket and he's going in to wash the windows. Now, I couldn't understand. If it's raining, the window's going to get wet anyway. Yeah. So what is the point of going and cleaning the windows? Now tell me, what is the point of that? Anyway, I went and saw the reason this man got a cheek. Why he's washing the windows? Because one young girl standing outside there by the window, and in the shorty pants she's wearing, she's drying the clothes, and bending and drying, and this man is washing the windows and looking through the windows. I'm telling you, if he carry on looking like that, and if he have a heart problem, I'm not going to rush him to hospital. He must sit at home with his heart problem. He know he got a weak heart, but you still want to look at things like that. Hey, but he's so lazy, I tell you. He only know to eat and sit. That is all he's been doing. Plus now there's few days too, you know, we can't stand in the same space with each other. So I told him, you know what, at least go buy bread and come yesterday. He's saying, no, you don't want to buy bread. I heard I must wear one nurse's uniform for him. Now at our age, you want to play role play. He got any brains, that man? Meanwhile, he's telling me not role play. I heard if I put the nurse's uniform out, I can go outside and buy the bread and no one will catch me. Can you believe he got such a cheek, this man? Eh? People have got a problem. The country got a problem. This man got a big mouth like this. Had to be so lazy. I was just so fed up. I sat down. I went to in a TikTok now. Yeah, I'm in the TikTok. You must follow me in the TikTok, right? I went to in a TikTok now. Now, you must know, so many days, I saw they got no story. She got no lies to talk about me. So, she didn't know what to. You know what she did? She went to follow me in the TikTok to see what I'm doing. But she don't know now in the TikTok when you're following me, I can see, I get the notification that you're following me. Now she realized that she can't, and then she quickly deleted it. But guess what? The notification came that she was checking my profile. Can you believe she got such a cheek? Who she's checking for? And she'll make all her friends come and add me on the Facebook and the Instagram and the TikTok and all, so she can see my stories. What a dirty habit she got, eh? Such a dirty habit. Hey, but I hope this lockdown is treating y'all all well. And I hope all your cupboards are clean. Now, y'all can't say y'all got no time to do it like this man here. Yeah? He'll say he got no time to do anything. You know what he did in the morning too? Early in the morning before we went for the pension, he's standing outside the house. The neighbor asking me, hey, Biggs, what you standing outside for? You know, they said nobody must stand outside the house unnecessarily. I heard, no, Dolly is singing inside the house. So he came here outside. I heard, wait, I'm screeching. Anyone will think he's eating me. Can you believe this man got such a cheek? Such a damn cheek. Anyway, before he come away now, let me go and quickly neaten up the house and make something to eat. Because, you know, he went with his sister and I don't know what stories will come with. Yeah, he'll come take the tales. Must see, when he talked to his sister on the phone, that time he can talk all day. But let me talk on two sentences. Hey, you say I'm nagging. Let him come. Then I'll show him what he's nagging. Right, eh? Nana poite vare.